Hello guys, and welcome back to the Darkest Web. Still playing Amnesia Dark Descent. Finally found the lever. So there we go. Don't know what happened to the guy. There he is. Nope, get up there. Timer. Okay. So I have to go all the way back there. Go, just go. Oh, I got another guy. Alright, well, this is no fun. Oh, is that lantern oil? Oh, it is. Oh boy, I don't know where I need to go. Another lever around here somewhere, or I'm hibiscally screwed. I'm not seeing a dang thing. Thank you. one's Attorney Bobby. Other side. Oh, God. Bless America. Stuck in there, isn't it? Yeah, all right, I'll take it. Away from you. Oh, that is stressful. Alright, glad I made it out of there, and there's no more water. Oh boy. This must be the inner sanctum. Yes, how lovely. How creepily lovely. All right. Sure.
You have an ascending room. Will it take us to the inner sanctum?
It will definitely take care of the vertical part of our journey. So, you have ridden an elevator before?
Yes, the Colosseum at Regent's Park has one. It takes you to the gallery where you can view the panorama.
Good. This ride might be a little longer, and in the other direction.
Alrighty. Noted. It's locked, alright. Just gonna go in a big fucking circle. Alright, so steady I go. Hubert's trunk was wrapped in rope. The lock had been broken by thieves. He assumed, wondered if anything had been left, considering. I have no idea what I'm doing. Oh look, good, a note. To my most trusted student and friend, John Weyer. The most remarkable thing happened as I was traveling through the Persian woods this summer. I finally found the orbs I have been looking for the last 20 odd years, and it's inexplicably as Heliodorus described in Hortus Circulus Conculus. Whatever. It was as told about blah 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 blah. Texture was smooth and jagged, color wash while rich, contrast is not enough to describe its nature. The partial artifact paradox captured with thin stone. Staying in a nearby village. I could feel underground chamber, I could feel I was trespassing. Because my curiosity did the best to fight these instincts and fetch the orb from its place, I scrambled out of the chamber into the woods. I could sense something was following me. It bayed loudly as it closed in. The beast is gargling in the guarding. The beast, this guardian of the orb, was relentless in its pursuit. Stumbled upon some men fishing in the lake. I tried to warn them as I passed, but fortunately they remained as I continued to escape. I heard their crying pain echo through the valley. Ooh. Alright. Your friend. Okay. Alright, so Ah, okay. Use you. Since I just wasted one. Oh. Oh. Well, this looks horrific. Oh boy. Anybody need a saw? I can saw you. Hold that. You failed. Oh, that's a creepy picture. Thank you. Oh, bones. Dog bones? No, I don't want to let you. More dogs. Lungs. Back muscle. Further disappointment, the Antiquarian's latest findings yielding nothing. I'm still unable to grasp the inner workings of life and its relation to the power I sense within it. I shall pursue more books on the subject, but I suspect it will be in vain since no research has been made in my particular interest. I must attempt to fill that void myself. Clearly, humans emanate more of the energy I seek, but I hope animals will suffice as a less of a hassle to acquire. Well, that didn't happen.
Let's see what you have to offer.
Not much. So that's a dead end. So okie dokie. Whatever you say there, boss. So what you're saying is I need a chair. Throw a chair at you. Oh, I gotta play this game, huh? I guess I could have came out this way. Oh no, I don't think I've been in this room. Ooh, looky there. When will it be my turn? Have I not shown restraint? My patience spans centuries. From where I came, mankind has not even wasted a breath, yet I bow to you. I have done so much for you, and I have gained nothing in return. Agappa. I trusted you. It was I who all in fairness should have entered that gate.
No.
Okay. Well, I got a gear here. Elevator breaks down again. Make sure to use the steam engine to build up pressure before changing it into the before channeling it into machinery. Adjust the levers to get the right amount of pressure inside the chamber. The meter should read up 8 and down 8. Make sure the flow is set according to the flow chart. Trinity shrimp set functions, 4-phase amplitude, complete stream flow cycle. Note that the machine will not check proper configurations until all rods are inserted. Okie dokie, I have no idea what I'm doing, but okay. Excuse me. Yeah, get your sanity back. Alright, dump that. I don't think there's anything else I need around here. Oh yeah, I wish I could take this with me.
Received a letter today from the Algerian governor's office disclosing the fate of Herbert's expedition. About a week after my departure, Abdullah, one of the men traveling with us, returned from the desert. He was badly injured, as if maimed by a lion. The man rambled deliriously about the expedition being attacked by something horrible. The French quickly dispatched a search party to look for the expedition. After searching for days, they found the camp abandoned without any trace of Herbert or his men. Tomorrow, I'll retrieve the things they recovered from Herbert's tent at the customs house. I don't know what to make of it, but I'm worried for him.
Worried for him? You should be worried for you. You're the one getting the stuff. Oh, I can't open the grand flood lock. Fine, I'll check you from the side. Nothing. Alrighty. Can I pick you up and I smash you, you huge cockroach? Crowbar apparently. Ah, for the door in it.
3rd of July, 1839. Today I picked up Herbert's things at the customs house. I dug through the trove of documents he had carried and found a log detailing the expedition. The nature of this text ranged from quick notes to colorful accounts of transpired events. I skimmed the pages, trying to figure out what might have happened. May 17th, the day I was trapped inside the orb chamber, Herbert dryly states, "Recovered Daniel after 1 hour of entrapment." This confused me greatly. I was suffocating within minutes. How could I have lasted an hour? I continued reading the peculiar text. Herbert states his facts without judgment or passion. But suddenly, I could read frustration into his text. He pushed his men to investigate the underground tomb, an effort which seems to have strained the minds of his men. Madness spread through the ranks, and Herbert had to take some extreme measures to continue. He finally visits the chamber himself, where he retrieves the orb to the surface. His account confuses me greatly. If he has the orb, what are those pieces in my drawing room?
Murray. Oh, okay. I didn't even know that was a thing.
Daniel.
What?
Still having nightmares, I see.
Yes. I can't shake them. They come every night.
We'll put a stop to them. You'll see.
Okay, sure. No? Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
July, 1839. It's done. The orb is assembled. I was awakened by an exhausting nightmare. Shaking and sweating, I retired to the drawing room with a cup of tea. The relic pieces lay spread across the table as I'd left them, but somehow I knew how it was supposed to be. I fetched the tar, which I had prepared to fix the pieces together, and without fault, I joined them, producing the orb I remembered so clearly. The tar proved unnecessary. It was pushed out from the joining pieces as they merged on their own, with no adhesive. The ancient stone relic now rests on my table. Its immaculate surface and perfect shape could have been molded by a factory. This is all too strange.
Sure, all too strange. Trying his best to keep himself from screaming. The medicine cabinet had been too far. I don't know. I'm trying. But this is all making no damn sense. Storage. Going into storage. Okay. Chest. Sure, thanks. Not what I need, but need that. Sure. That way in a minute. explosive you need for clearing the flood drain. I can't express enough how important it is that the mixture is handled with care. Please try to tell your feather-brained servants this before you go ahead with the plans. Little goods are not by themselves explosive and should keep separated to avoid further missteps. I have arranged two large vats in the next room for the ingredients. All you need to do is mix the liquids and you are ready to go. Thanks, buddy. Machine pots, of course it is. Mementos. The rubble from the cave is hindering further passage to storage. Find a way through to get through it. An important key is hidden in the guest room. Yes, I know, I have to go back there. Find the key that unlocks the door leading to the machine room. Yeah. I set it off? Oh, I know. See crap. Thank you. Torch, candle. Ah, there's a torch. There's a torch. And there's a torch. Alrighty. Witchcraftery. Well, some full set of three rods is available. There's one rod in the inner study rooms, which might work in case the elevator breaks down again. Unless it's absolutely necessary, always use the spare rods in the storage before using a mended one. Thanks. I'll keep that in mind. Places I can hide. How did you even catch up to me? Like, how? Like, how did you catch up to me? darkness can act as a cover, but I have like everything fully lit because I ran out of lamp juice. Still won't budge. Yeah. Wrong button. Wrong button. Stop crouching and run your ass off. Sadly, this is where I'm going to end this episode. So, thank you guys for watching, and as always, like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next episode. That is Dante Cordon. Bye-bye.